1952, the greatest year in Tech football history, had many outstanding highlights. It marked the first time any team had six All-American players. Offensive captain and right tackle, Hal Miller, a great blocker and fine team leader. Defensive captain, George Morris, the key factor in Tech's great defense, which ranked number two in the country. Offensive right end, Buck Martin, a great pass receiver and fine blocker as well. Offensive center, Pete Brown, one of the truly great blockers in Tech's long football history. Defensive left half, Bobby Moorhead, one of the big reasons Tech did not have a single pass scored against it all year long. And offensive halfback, Leon Hardeman, one of the truly great runners of all time at Georgia Tech. Season in Georgia Tech football history opened against the Citadel at Grant Field. This was the first of a tough 11-game schedule. In the opening period, Tech marked its first score of the year on Larry Ruffin's great 32-yard dash off tackle. After Tech later still driving deep in Citadel territory, Dick Pretz sweeps the end for 26 yards in Tech's third score. Still in the first quarter, Leon Hardeman races for 20 yards around the end. Tech scores four times in the first 7 minutes. Here, Leon Hardeman climaxes the first period tallying with a 30-yard dash around the end as Tech goes on to maul Citadel 54-6. Tech's first conference battle of 1952 was against the Florida Gators. It was a grueling game, a truly bitter battle, in which the issue was in doubt until the final minutes of play. In the opening period, Florida, on a sustained drive, drove deep in Georgia Tech territory. Then on fourth down and goal to go at the Georgia Tech 6-yard line, Buford Long, right half, slashes off tackle for 6 yards and a touchdown. Florida leads 7-0. Georgia Tech fights back. Starting a sustained drive, Leon Hardeman smashes for 13 yards on a trap play up the middle. four plays later, sophomore quarterback Billy Brigman takes to the air, spots Buck Martin for a 13-yard touchdown pass. It's now 7-7. That's the way it was at halftime. In the third quarter, left half Jay Papa Hall breaks clean and races 64 yards to put Florida ahead again, 14-7. In the fourth quarter, trailing by a touchdown, tack on the Florida 35. Brigman passes and Jeff Knox makes a great circus catch. It's tied 14-14. Now Tech must race against the clock. It's late in the ball game. A quick pass to Martin from Brigman's complete. The quarterback again takes to the air. This time he heaves one to Jeff Knox, and Tech is threatening. Now left half Leon Hardiman cracks down on the Florida 6. On a fourth down play from the Florida 6-yard line, Pepper Edgers kicks a field goal. It's good. Tech beats Florida 17-14. Cool, clear night in Dallas, Texas, Georgia Tech meets the SMU Mustangs at the Cotton Bowl. This was the third game in their series, each having won one game in the past. Georgia Tech showed its greatest offensive weapons of the year in this great game against the Mustangs of SMU, carrying the game to SMU all the way. First quarter, Glenn Turner slashes for 21 yards, and Tech is driving. The now famous belly play, Leon Hardiman takes off around right end and goes all the way to the SMU 9. Again, it's Hardiman carrying the mail. This time on one of his most determined drives for 9 yards and a score as 9 men hit him, but nobody can stop him. Tech leads SMU 7-0. It's SMU's ball. From the double wing set, Roy Pace is back to throw. He fires a pass, but George Morris intercepts for Tech, giving the Jackets the ball on the SMU 31. From this spot, Billy Tease takes off on the belly play around left end and goes all the way to give Tech a 14-0 lead. Hardiman driving inside, cracks down to the SMU 6. And Tech climaxes its great first half scoring against the Mustangs when Billy Tease skirts left end for 6 big points to give Tech a 20-0 lead. The Jackets go on to coast in the second half and whip the Mustangs 20-7. Was Tulane Greenway. They gave Tech a bitter defensive battle. Although Tech gained over 400 yards against Tulane, they couldn't score until the last minute of both halves. With 3 minutes to go in the first half, Bill Brigman starts a drive, a completed pass to Buck Martin. Bill again takes to the air, continuing his aerial bombardment. He again spots big Buck Martin, and Tech is really moving. Now for the third consecutive play, it's Brigman pitching and Martin catching. But this drive stalled and Tulane takes over with a minute to go in the first half. Now Tulane takes to the air. Pete Clement, their quarterback, fades to throw. He fires it and Jakey Rudolph intercepts for Georgia Tech, giving the Jackets the ball inside the Tulane 40. Now with 10 seconds to go in the first, Brigman is back to throw a long one. He fakes to the left. Then heaves a tremendous pass down the middle. There's Buck Martin wide open, and Tech leads at the half 7-0. Herman drive by the Yellow Jackets late in the game net their second score. Hardeman circles right in for 35 yards. Tech goes on to score again and whip Tulane 14-0. Tech's fifth game of the year was against their traditional rivals, the Auburn Tigers. The cries of War Eagle could be heard everywhere, and the Auburn team came to town. Tech won an easy victory over Auburn, though, 33-0. First quarter, Dudley Spence back to pass for the Tigers. Loops one that Bobby Moorhead nares for Tech, and he races down the sidelines, 47 yards for the game's first score. It's 7-0 Tech. A moment later, freshman Bob James fumbles. George Marsh recovers for Tech at the Auburn 6. On the first play from the Auburn 6-yard line, Billy Tease cuts outside left end, races in for the score, and it's 14-0 Tech. The Tigers again take to the air. Dudley Spence back to throw. Fires one down the middle. Deflected by Larry Morris. Intercepted by Bobby Moorhead. And Moorhead races to his second touchdown. And Tech leads 21-0. Tech's homecoming game for 1952 was against the Vanderbilt Commodores at Grant Field. Before a tremendous crowd, Georgia Tech played host to Vanderbilt and their fabulous freshman, Bill Kreidemeyer. Here's the beginning of an 83-yard touchdown march by Tech. Glenn Turner ripping 21 yards up the middle on a trap play. Now on a pitch out, Leon Hardeman circles in for 14 more yards. And another Tech first down. From the Vanderbilt 41, Hardeman again takes off. This time, nobody can stop him. The fabulous Hardeman goes all the way on a spectacular dash. It's 7-0 Tech.
Zion of the sun.
Durham, North Carolina, before 50,000 fans, unbeaten Georgia Tech plays unbeaten Duke in the game of the day in the country. It's homecoming for the Blue Devils. A great crowd is on hand to see these two bitter rivals. In the first quarter, on the belly play, Leon Hardeman goes from the Tech 40 to the Duke 34 on a great run. Tech is on the move. It's fourth down and four at the Duke 26. Glenn Turner slices off tackle. He crashes for 18 yards and a Tech first down at the Duke 8. It's goal to go. Three plays later on fourth down, Billy Tease crashes over for the score. Tech leads Duke 7-0. Moments later, Worth loses back the boot. Bob Sherman blocks the kick. Cecil Traynor recovers for Tech at the Duke 18. Three plays later, carry to the Duke 5, then Glenn Turner bulls his way over for the touchdown, and Tech leads Duke 14-0. In the second period, Billy T sneaks around left end, starting from the Duke 42. He goes all the way to the Duke 1 yard line. It's first down, goal to go for the Jackets. Now on the wedge play the Tech used so successfully all day against Duke, Hardeman scores Tech's third TD, and it's 21-0 at the half. Third quarter, Lutz back to boot. It's partially blocked by Sam Hensley. It'll be Tech's ball at the Duke 35-yard line as the Jackets outplay Duke all the way. Tech reached a terrific peak, and here back on a fourth down pass is Bill Brigman. It's good to Jeff Knox. Tech wins 28-7.
Yell to hell with Georgia like his daddy used to do. Ramblin' Wreck. white and gold, down with
the red and black.
Georgia Tech is up for a victory. We'll drop the battle axe
on Georgia's head.
When we meet her, our team will surely beat her. Down on the old farm,
there will be no sound
till our bow wows rip through the air. When the battle is over,
Georgia's team will be found
with the yellow jackets swarming round the rack.
It's the first invasion by Army into the Southland. First quarter, fourth down for Tech. Dave Davis back to boot. He gets off one of the greatest kicks of all time. An 80-yard punt that rolls dead on the Army one-inch line. Army is forced to kick back. Taya is back to boot for Army. His kick is blocked by Roger Fry. Fry also recovers the ball for Tech at the Army 3. There's time in the half for just one more play before the first half ends. Bill Brigman runs his team. He passes to Buck Martin, and Tech leads at the half 24-6. Alabama Crimson Tide was Tech's ninth opponent of the year. In the first game to be nationally televised from the Southeast, upset-minded Alabama carried the game to Tech. Long Bama drive came on Bobby Luna's 15-yard field goal. Alabama leads Tech 3-0. Bama again threatens, and Tech must come up with a great goal line stand to stop this second determined effort. Corky Tharp is stopped on the Georgia Tech 1. It's third down, goal to go for Bama. Quarterback Clell Hobson on the quarterback keep play is spilled at the 3 by Sam Hensley. It's fourth down and 3. Now one of the defensive highlights of the year. Bobby Marlowe and his touchdown bid is spilled by Jakey Rudolph. Tech on offense. On the belly play, Billy T circles the end for a big first down for the Jackets. This 35-yard gain put the Jackets in business. Here, Dick Kretz on the belly play to the right picks up 18 yards and another Tech first down. Two plays later from the 9-yard line, Kretz again starts out around right end. This time, nobody can stop him. Dick goes in for the touchdown. It's 7-3 Tech. Late in the game in the fourth quarter, Bama again threatens. On fourth down, 4 at the Tech 14, Hobson is back to pass. The score is still 7-3 Tech. Here's an important play. It's incomplete, broken up by Charlie Brannon, whose great defensive effort saved the day. Now Tech must keep possession. Glenn Turner drives for 14 yards and a first down. We're in the waning moment of the football game. Again, it's Turner driving hard for Tech. His great offensive play highlights the day as he rips off 35 yards and a Tech first down. It's all over now, and Georgia Tech beats Alabama 7-3. Florida State Seminoles make their first appearance on Grant Field in the semifinal of Tech's regular season schedule. Tech scores the first time they get the ball. Chapel Rhino races for 30 yards around end. After Tech racks up two more first downs, Bobby Gilliland starts around right end from the Florida State 12. He goes all the way and Tech leads 7-0. One of the longest downs in the game came on Glenn Turner's great run up the middle of 62 yards. Now one of the record-breaking events of the year for Tech, a point after touchdown kicked by Pepa Rogers. His 18th straight to break an all-time SEC record as Tech beats Florida State 30-0.
As for the University of Georgia,
I'd rather see him in hell!
To hell, to hell, to hell with Georgia. To hell, to hell, to hell with Georgia. To hell, to hell, to hell with Georgia. The cesspool of the South. My eyes have seen the glory of the stomping of the dogs. We will teach the board on farm boys they should stick to slopping hogs. When the Jackets are triumphant, there will be a mighty cheer.
Tech journey to Athens for the finale of the year with Georgia. It was one of the most exciting and dramatic games in the long history of these two ancient rivals. Georgia was keyed up and played a superb ball game against the favored Yellow Jackets, who, like a great champion, had to come from behind to win it. Here's how it happened. After Tech fumbled on the very first play of the game, Georgia carried the ball to the Georgia Tech 3 on Foots Clemens' 9-yard run. On the very next play, Clemens slants off tackle. He goes all the way and leads Georgia to a 7-0 lead over Tech. Tech fights back. Billy tees, heads around left end. Goes for 18 yards on a Tech first down. On a tremendous effort, Glenn Turner cracks for 20 yards down to the Georgia 20-yard line. Here the attack was stalled, so on fourth down, from the Georgia 10, Pepper Rogers kicks a field goal. The score at halftime, 7-3, Georgia. In the third quarter, Tech began its most important and determined drive of the year. Dick Pratt slashes off tackle for 6 yards, the beginning of a long 65-yard drive to pay dirt. On a fourth down gamble, Pepper Rogers, quarterback, sneaks for a first down, and Tech keeps possession of the ball. Glenn Turner slashes off tackle for 8 yards, and Tech is really moving. Again, it's Big Glenn, the fullback, who was a great ball player for Tech this day, smashing for 8 more yards on a wedge play straight ahead. 2 plays later, it's fourth down and 4 at the Georgia 10. Brigman pitches out to Rhino. Rhino leaps and throws to Buck Martin. Touchdown, Tech, and it's 10-7 in favor of the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets. Georgia strikes. Here, Burkowski, who was a great passer all day against Tech, flips one to left end, Johnny Carson, and the Bulldogs have it on the Tech 3. One of the big plays in the football game is coming up. It's fourth down, goal to go on the Tech 3. Burkowski hands off to Madison. He's filled by Joe Hall and Larry Mars giving Tech the ball. Here, Tech gave Georgia a safety, and the score was 10-9. Now later in the game, Burkowski takes to the air. A great catch by Bobby Dellinger puts Georgia in Tech territory again. 3 plays later on fourth down, Burkowski shoots for his touchdown. He throws to Johnny Carson. He's got it. He dropped it. Jakey Rudolph's great tackle saves the day for Tech. Now late in the game, still trailing by a single point. Burkowski passes. It's deflected, intercepted by Bobby Moore, head of Tech, who runs it all the way back to the Georgia 1. The game clincher is Pepper Rogers' quarterback sneak to make it 16-9. In the final minute, Tech scores again when Glenn Turner races 14 yards off tackle for the final score. It makes it 23-9 as Tech has its greatest year and goes undefeated, untied, into the Sugar Bowl on New Year's Day. Before 83,000 fans in the Sugar Bowl, Georgia Tech climaxes its greatest year against Ole Miss. First quarter, Georgia Tech kicks off and Ole Miss gets right down to business. Jimmy Lear completes a pass for a first down to Wilson Dillard. On the next play, Lear, the fine split-tee quarterback, again takes to the air. This time he completes one to his halfback Moorhead, and Ole Miss is on their way. Powerful halfback Wilson Dillard cracks down to the Tech 15, and the Rebels are really threatening. Then 4 plays later, on fourth down from the 1, Dillard smashes in for the touchdown, and Ole Miss leads Georgia Tech after 3.5 minutes, 7-0.
Jimmy Lear fades back, looks for Jim Slay. His pass is in the air, Slay grabs it, shakes loose from two Tech tacklers, and races for the goal line. It looks like he might go all the way, but here comes George Morris up from behind to dump him on the 5-yard stripe. First down, just 5 yards to go for a TD, and Dillard hits center for 2 yards. Ole Miss up the line of scrimmage. Here's Lofton carrying to the 2-yard line where Larry Morris stops him. Now Jimmy Lear keeps the ball, tries to go at right guard, but he slips and falls for no gain. Fourth down, 2 yards to go. Ole Miss has one more chance to punch it across. Dillard takes the pitch out, tries to sweep right end, but Moorhead and Rudolph stop him on the 3.
This long drive is climaxed on third down on a 6-yard burst of speed by Hardiman around the end. It's Tech 17, Ole Miss 7. Moments later, Hardiman, voted the game's outing player, is off again. This brilliant 35-yard touchdown gallop was called back for a penalty. In the fourth quarter, the final touchdown play is a long pass from Pepper Rogers to Jeff Knox. As Georgia Tech whips Ole Miss and climaxes its greatest year, 24-7 in the Sugar Bowl.
We wanted to win. We wanted to win. And we had good athletes. We had, you know, some good players.
And George Morris was one of the best for the undefeated and national champion 1952 Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets.
The unbeaten Georgia Tech team races onto the field from the south gate.
Coach Dodd at a luncheon back in the 80s in front of my dad's peers to refer to my dad as the greatest player that he ever coached.
He's always Coach Dodd to me. You'd have to beat me to say Bobby Dodd, yeah. You know.
A great coach, a great team, and the heyday of Georgia Tech football. And Morris was in the middle of it all.
Captain Cal Miller and George Morris of Georgia Tech.
He was really smart. He understood the game extremely well, and that's what Coach Dodd liked about him.
However, this time, Spires fumbles, and George Morris recovers for Tech in the Ole Miss 44.
And we did a lot of things on defense that a lot of people in the country were not doing because of experience level and intelligence level.
The accolades that Morris has received are numerous.
These are just some of the scrapbooks that I've gotten. He had an opportunity to be on the Jackie Gleason show. One thing that was kind of cool, they all had nicknames for one another. Like my dad's nickname was The Head. He was drafted by the San Francisco 49ers as the first round draft pick. I think it was 5 or 6 overall that year.
And his career didn't end there. Morris then became a referee for the Southeastern Conference for 2 decades.
He could handle the sidelines real well. He could communicate with the coaches, and he loved being around the players. And he was a very good football official.
And all the time, Morris made his mark in his adopted home of Atlanta, a city that brought him from Mississippi, and a city that will honor him February 6th.
But here comes George Morris up from behind to dump him on the 5-yard stripe.
He was a really great football player on a really great team that was coached by a number of really great men.
Cody Chaffins, Fox 5 Sports.
Whiskey clear. I'm a rambling wreck from Georgia Tech and a hell of an engineer. Well, if I had a daughter, sir, I'd dress her in white and gold and put her on the canvas to cheer the brave and bold. Well, if I had a son, sir, I'd tell you what he'd do. He would yell to hell with Georgia like his daddy used to do. I wish I had a barrel of rum and sugar 3,000 pounds, a college bell to put it in and clapper to stir it round. I drink to all good fellows who come from far and near. I'm a rambling, gambling, hell of an engineer. Hey!